how tasty of a victory is that for you yesterday when that victory is squarely on the shoulders of the defense?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. The yo-yo continues, but when it comes up, man, it's pretty damn good. So, yeah, I mean, I was a little worried early when, you know, we had three turnovers in the first half and we only got, 3 points out of it?
Yep.
And then they just kept rolling, man. They just kept, you know, Matt Judon had a phenomenal game. Sizzle, you know, still continued to play at a high level. We're going to get 5 turnovers. We're going to be pretty dang good. So I enjoyed it.
How does a defense keep from getting frustrated when, you know, they set up the offense, they say, here you go, gift-wrapped ball, we got you guys in great position, offense doesn't capitalize. If I'm you, and I'm known to get frustrated over the tiniest of things, but if I'm you and I'm getting back out there over and over again and handing the ball back to them and they're not really doing what they should with it, how do you, as a defenseman, not like throw your damn hands up and say, like, guys, why are we trying so hard? You're not doing anything with this.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you got to focus on your job. And I'm not going to say guys don't get frustrated. I mean, shoot, my first, before Joe got there, I mean, other than, 2006 and 2003, you know, we were not very good on offense, and we were always ranked top 5 in defense. So you're talking about years and years of play like that. And, you know, we always had a saying that it was just our opportunity to get back out on the field and show how good we were, you know, more face time for us. And you just got to keep rolling. You can't worry about it. Our offense is light years better than what it was back then. But you know, all in all, they played consistent and played a high level the entire game. And we came away with a shutout victory. So the offense did punch it in a couple times, and boom, there we go.
Talk to us about they had talked on the broadcast, Justin Forsett and Jerry and Stan said in the beginning of the game, it looks like the defense were playing kind of like a containment type thing. This Hundley guy, apparently, if you let him get outside, he'll pop off some yards on you. Talk to us about that was a big thing you did when you played here, obviously, outside linebacker, setting the edge, keeping the containment, and making sure nobody gets outside you.
Well, I mean, you're talking about two different things. You're talking about in the running game, you know, in our base defense, when I was standing up, and talking about, you know, the edge of the defense, turning everything back, not getting out flanked or anything like that. What they're talking about with the quarterback is in your pass rush. You got to stay in your pass rush lanes, and if you don't, you got to have a guy that spies the quarterback. And Aaron Rodgers, you know, he gets so much attention with his throwing ability and his arm talent and all those things, but you know his legs they can hurt you just as bad. This young kid's the same way. It's pretty uncanny how much he looks and acts just like Aaron Rodgers, and it's pretty unbelievable. So that was a big concern for them, being that they are such a good passing offense. They were going to have to play some man coverage. Anytime you play man coverage with a guy that can run, you know, you can give up a lot of yards to him scrambling downfield. But, man, they got after it. They rushed the passer really well. You know, they stayed in their lanes. I mean, you can't say enough about how well the defense played.
Are you starting to feel a little bit better about this Ravens team? I mean, I know they're 500, but of the 5 wins that they've had, 3 of them have been shutouts against, it's always been difficult to beat Cincinnati, much less Cincinnati, and they did. And then they've never won at Lambeau. And then here they go, 23-0. Obviously, everyone will continue to say without Aaron Rodgers. But they have, 5 games left. And outside of Pittsburgh, who, you know, they're at this point, they've got the AFC North locked up. And
yeah, they're playing good.
Yeah, they're kicking ass right now. There's really nobody else in there that I'm like, I'm going to lose sleep over. Are you starting to see some glimmers of hope for maybe a wild card run?
Man, I'm kind of sick of trying to figure this team out. I'm just going to enjoy the weeks when they play phenomenal.
Gotcha.
Especially when they play good on defense like this. The weeks they come out and play bad, I can't explain why. I can't sit and watch the game copy and, you know, come up with a reason why. I'm just going to enjoy the victories that we do get, and I know they're doing the same. And you know, like I said in the last big victory, I hope they you know, build a little momentum off of this and carry it in the next week and get rolling, because you know, this team, it has showed when it's good, it can be really good. And I know people like to say, oh, that team didn't have Aaron Rodgers. I don't care if you beat Cleveland by 100. Every victory in the NFL is valuable. And you'll take everyone, you'll get back on that plane, and you'll celebrate, and you'll show up on Monday morning and be happy about it. Just like when you lose, you show up on Monday morning, and it sucks. So every victory, you're going to enjoy, and I hope they carry it in the next week.
Green being Anderson.
Well, JJ, I don't know if you heard earlier, but a nightmarish scenario played out yesterday when we got on the Ravens charter, and there was mechanical failures, and we had to wait 4 hours for another plane to show up. In your times traveling, have you ever had any any such nightmare?
Yeah, that sucks. Did they let you off the plane?
Yeah, eventually, after like 2 hours of sitting in 130-degree heat.
Pushed his ass out when there were 5,000 feet.
130-degree heat. Easy, Anderson.
It was at least 90.
I've had a couple bad ones on like a, you know, just a regular commercial flight. And probably my worst one was on a charter flight my senior year when we were at Alabama. We were flying to Hawaii to play a fake bowl game because we were on probation. And we were going to land in Oakland, refuel, fly to Hawaii. We get to Oakland at like, I don't know, like 7 a.m. and the plane breaks. So they take like all these guys, all these football, they put us in this tiny little building and we sit there for like 10 hours.
You start looking at who you're going to eat, who's going to fight
It was miserable. You know, of course, everybody's just complaining. And so finally they were like, all right, let's get a hotel room. So they get it. They scramble up some buses. They book a hotel room. We go lay down, get to the hotel room. We're all exhausted. Get to the hotel. We're there maybe 30 minutes, and they're like, plane's ready. Go back.
Okay, thanks. Yeah. We're in that closet for 10 hours. Jarret Johnson, you're going to hear him Wednesday night as opposed to the usual Thursday night. Wednesday night for the Jarret Johnson Show at 6 o'clock. Jarret, we're not going to talk to you before next week. So have a great show Wednesday. Have a great Thanksgiving.
What's the plan?
Yeah, you too, boys.
What are the plans?
Go eat too much.
You going to fill up that big, giant mansion of yours with family and friends?
No, dude, actually, I don't have to cook this year. This is awesome. We're going Wednesday, going to the in-laws. Thursday, going to my sister's over in Tallahassee. Do the thing with my family. So we're just showing up, bringing wine, and hanging out.
That's what's up, buddy. Do it right. Do it right. Yeah. Hey, we'll ask you the question. We're going to ask people coming up, 410-338-1098, 410-338-1098. What's the most disgusting thing at the Thanksgiving table? You see that dish put in front of you? You say, throw that in a trash can.
Yeah. You know, I'm not a big fan. If stuffing is really good, it's really good. But bad stuffing to me is just like...
Because it's such a... soggy, flavorless bread. Yes.
Yeah.
I look so forward to stuffing.
The good stuffing.
Like good stuffing. And then when it sucks, you're like, really?
How did you mess this up? Oh, Grandma. Hey, Grandma. You. How about that?